Neurofeedback brain training, how it works. I'm Dr. Trish Leigh. In this video, I want to share with you how neurofeedback brain training can and does work. I hear from people all the time, I'm a skeptic. I don't get at all how this could possibly work. So I want you to know that, first of all, there's thousands of scientific studies that proves that neurofeedback brain training works for a wide variety of mental and physical health issues. Now, what people don't understand is that those mental and physical health issues are actually brain dysfunction problems. And my goal is to help people understand that, because once you understand the underlying mechanisms, it totally makes sense how neurofeedback works. That's my goal in sharing that with you today. So the idea is that if you struggle with anxiety, attention, arousal dysfunction, autoimmune disorders, neurodevelopmental disorders like speech and language problems, like ADHD, motor problems, if you struggle with neurodegenerative issues like Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, ALS, all of these things are brain dysfunctions. If you struggle with internet addictions or addictions of any other flavor, they at their core are brain dysfunction problems. So brain dysfunction is driving the symptoms of the mind and the body that a person experiences, because certain areas of the brain are not using electrical energy in the optimal pattern. So the way that I identify that is through something that's called a qEEG brain map. And now, through the wonders of technology, using a professional online portal, I'm able to map a person's brain anywhere in the world. You actually take the map by yourself, but then it populates automatically into the professional portal. And we get on a Zoom, I share my screen, and I can go through your entire map with you in the hour Zoom meeting that we have. I show you where all the areas of dysfunction are and the levels. So a qEEG brain map uses something called electroencephalogram. The Q stands for quantitative. It's a measurable electroencephalogram, which basically is like a snapshot of how your brain is performing over the amount of time that the data is read from the sensors in the hardware that you use at home. So you use a piece of technology that has sensors in it, and we're able to then collect data that gets processed and uploaded, so then it becomes a visual representation. And on the brain map, what you can see is that the brain map should be all green. I call that the green zone. When your brain is operating with an all green brain map, it means that every single area can shift in and out of the different brain speeds seamlessly, which means you can get into the state that you need to based on the circadian rhythms, the flow of the day. So the way that it works is, when you get up, you might feel groggy, but then you're having coffee and you feel calm and alert, but you're not yet thinking and using your brain. That's a great feeling, right? Coffee clutch time is one of my favorite times. Then it's time to focus at work, and you can get into calm focus. You really have to figure out a problem, you can hyper-focus on it. Somebody runs in and they have a crisis, you can help them with that stressful situation. And once it's solved, they leave and you can bring your brain back down to calm focus again. It's time to go to lunch, you can just shift into calm, chill with your cronies, have a nice lunchtime, go back to work, calm focus. Need to really figure out something again? Focus again. But then it's time for dinner with your family. You can relax and have a nice dinner. Then you relax before bed and you start to feel groggy again. You get in bed. It takes 20 minutes to fall asleep. Your brain catches the sleep cycle and you sleep like a baby. And 8 hours later, you wake up refreshed and do it all over again. Green brain map. Circadian rhythms, automatic transmission, shifting in and out of the gears. Now, if you struggle with any of the things that I just talked about, especially anxiety, attention issues, if you have autoimmune disorders, if you have arousal dysfunction, if you keep going back to the screen, what it means is your brain is not using the green zone brain map. Instead, it's acting like a manual transmission. And that manual transmission is stuck in a gear and it cannot get to the other gears. So likely it's stuck in the gears of wired and tired. The wired and tired gears make you feel anxious, make it difficult to focus and attend and be motivated. When that happens, the screen pulls you in because it's going to give your brain dopamine and take the edge off the wired and tired pattern for a time. Unfortunately, screen time in and of itself makes the wired and tired pattern worse. The more you're in the screen, the worse it gets. So you find yourself caught in this loop of wired and tired and not being able to use that automatic transmission of flow in your brain. So now you get permanently stuck in these gears. Now I want to be clear, there's two types of ways you can get stuck. One I call an organic pattern. So an organic pattern is like ADHD. Your brain was born with the use of too much slow speed, quote unquote tired. And that becomes a driving force across your life. But we know now that with technology, that brain pattern can be healed, even if it is organic. The other brain pattern is more environmental, like screen time. If you keep going back into the screen, you keep exposing your brain to something that is creating and reinforcing that dysfunctional brain pattern. So the solution is twofold. When I help people, what I do is I regulate the brain to heal the dysfunction using high-level technology, neurofeedback. Then I also provide coaching to make sure you interact with the environment in a way that facilitates healthy brain functioning and does not take you away from your goal of feeling calm and focused and present and alive in your real-world life. So the way neurofeedback works is once we identify that dysfunctional brain pattern, then what we can do is I set the neurofeedback system to reduce the amount of the gears that you're stuck in and increase the amount of the gears you can't get to anymore internally. Those gears are basically the five main brain speeds that are for sleep, falling asleep, feeling calm and focused, and feeling stressed. So typically I'm decreasing the wired stress brainwave, brain speed. I'm decreasing the tired, lack of focus brain speed, and I'm increasing the speeds in the middle so that you can feel calm and focused. But I set the system specifically and directly for the needs in your brain. It's an individual program, neurofeedback. You get what you need. And the beauty of the way that I do it is we collect all the data possible and I'm constantly showing you that data of your brain improving over the 4-month program. You see so much data, you know your brain is changing, you know it's getting stronger, you know it's responding to the workout of neurofeedback. Now, what is the workout of neurofeedback like? It's a passive modality, meaning you don't have to think about it. You don't have to do anything. What you do have to do is do the workout. So I liken it to bicep curls. If you want to get a strong bicep, you don't have to think, wow, I want my bicep stronger. And you don't have to go to a therapist and talk about it over and over. How do I get this bicep stronger? What you have to do is get 20-pound weights and start repping out bicep curls to make your biceps stronger. When you can do a lot of curls and then they're not hard anymore, now we need to swap out the 20-pound weights for 30-pound weights. Keep repping, swap out the 30 for 40, keep repping, and your biceps will get stronger. You don't even have to think about it. Neurofeedback works in the same way. So when you use the technology, you do sessions, you put the technology on your head, the sensors. And when you do that, what happens is the sensors only read what's going on in your brain and feed you feedback in the form of audio and visual feedback. So in the specialized app, you can pick videos, you can pick games, you can pick audio. I mostly recommend that people start with video, so it's very passive. You pick a video that you love and you turn it on. And during the session, when your brain is in the zone, when it's closer to the green zone, the video plays bright and the audio plays louder. When your brain goes out of that zone, the video goes dim and the audio goes lower. And Einstein characterized our brain as the most complex and amazing thing in the universe. It will work to regulate itself when it's pushed in the right direction. Essentially, that's what neuroplasticity is. We're going to push your brain in the right direction with this workout. And we're going to start you with 20-pound weights of the brain. And the system will automatically threshold. It'll automatically make it more difficult the better you do. It's automatically swapping out the 20-pound weights for the 30-pound weights. And it gives you an announcement that it's done it. So you know your brain is getting stronger. You can see the level of weight that it put on for you. All you have to do is keep using it. And then I analyze the data with you and I show you the improvements that are being made. You know your brain is changing and you know you feel less anxious. You know you can attend and focus more. You know you don't have to go into the screen anymore. You feel and perform better as your brain performance improves, and you can see it with your own eyes through the wonders of technology and neuroplasticity. So if you're interested in neurofeedback or qEEG brain map, please go over to drtrishleigh.com. Check out the qEEG brain map page. That's the first step, because we need to know what your brain is doing and the level of dysfunction, the healing gap that's in there. Once we see that, then we know exactly what your brain needs to heal, and I can set the system to do the work for you. All right. I hope that helps you understand neurofeedback. And until next time, control your brain, or it'll control you.